My name is Marek, and I'm a final year student studying medicine. So how am I taught in my degree? Well, medicine is a 5-year degree, and we can split that 5 years into being either preclinical, which is years 1 and 2, and clinical, which is years 3, 4, and 5. A lot of the teaching that you'll receive in your preclinical years tends to be lecture and seminar based. Alongside this, you'll also have anatomy and lab practicals as well, and this means that you'll basically be provided with lots of opportunities to sort of build and consolidate knowledge, and also sort of have opportunities to speak to your course members as well. The teaching that you'll receive in years 3, 4, and 5 differs to this slightly, as it's a lot more hands-on. So you'll spend a lot of time in either community-based medicine, such as GPs, or hospital-based, and that can include rotations in obs and gyne, pediatrics, and mental health as well. And all of this ward-based experience will sort of allow you to have an opportunity to sort of actually use the skills that you've built in your preclinical years and also gain some hands-on experience. So does any of my teaching take place outside of the classroom? The answer to that is yes. In medicine, a lot of your teaching will be taking place outside of lecture theatres and seminars. In your preclinical years, this will involve things such as anatomy practicals and lab-based experience, whereas in your clinical years, so years 3, 4, and 5, a lot of the learning will take place in clinical environments such as GP practices and hospitals. Essentially, the type of assessments that you'll experience and encounter throughout your degree studying medicine at Newcastle University will vary depending on which year you're in. One of the most common assessments that you'll do in almost each year includes a multiple choice paper question, which is also known as a single best answer. However, alongside this, you'll also partake in written assessments and OSCEs as well. Although these assessments can be quite daunting, and they're definitely hard work, the whole process can be made a lot easier, and some of the things that I found helpful when preparing for these included working with friends. So sharing ideas and bouncing ideas off one another I found very helpful. It also allowed an opportunity for us to sort of highlight any areas of weaknesses that we may have had. For my multiple choice paper questions, I found question banks really helpful, and some of the most common ones that people use throughout the degree include PassMed and also the QuestMed question banks. So do I have regular meetings with academic tutors? The answer to that is yes. Throughout my degree, regardless of what degree you're doing, you'll have the opportunity to have regular contact with an appointed academic tutor. And I found this very helpful because it allows me to ensure that if I have any questions, if I have any worries or concerns, I always have someone to speak to about these. And they're always really helpful, and you'll be able to meet them on a regular basis as well. So how do I organize my time for independent study? It can be a bit difficult to navigate how to sort of split up your days to ensure that you're still able to incorporate your lectures, your seminars, and also sort of make the most of your independent time as well. And throughout my degree, what I found the most helpful was to use calendars and to use to-do lists. So whether this is a physical calendar in your room or whether this is an online calendar, I just found it really helpful to sort of split up my tasks and sort of allow each day to be structured. This also meant that I was able to set aside time to sort of relax and do things that weren't directly related to my course to ensure that I'm not being burnt out as well.